Okay.
Jai Baba. So today we are gonna start up with vegetable pulao, and we'll also do a side dish of the same, like maybe like a salad, just a cucumber salad. So I have made many things ready. Like I have chopped mixed vegetables here. I have chopped it in a big chunky pieces because we want the taste, the flavors to come in while it's just, well cooked with all the flavors. If we do a fine chopping of all the vegetables here, like cauliflower, I have carrots, I have green beans, and I also have capsicum here. So these vegetables, we wanted to have a nice, chunky texture in our pulao. Also, I have big potato cubes. These are just in water. These are raw. These are not cooked. We have kept it in water so that it doesn't darken. We have 1 cup rice. These are big rice. I have soaked it in water for 15 minutes. These are, I can show you the size. These are basmati rice, especially for pulao, we use it. Then we have onions, tomatoes, just a single onion, single tomato, 4 to 5 nice spicy hot green chilies that are sliced here. I haven't fine chopped it because if we want, we can remove it while eating. Otherwise, if the spice comes directly, then, dangerous. Yeah, and also we have dry spices, raw spices like bay leaf, peppercorn, star anise, and cumin seeds, few cumin seeds. These actually add some spice. These are not just called raw spices or dry spices, but it actually adds spice. So we are using it in a lesser quantity because we are already using green chili. Now here I have ginger garlic paste. This is two garlic cloves and 1.5 inch ginger in it. And these are nice fresh curry leaves. These are 10 to 15 we'll be using. Finely chopped coriander leaves. We have clear butter. Clear butter. This is ghee. This nice ghee. Then salt as per required. We have sunflower oil, clear sunflower oil for our tadka, and mustard seeds. So here I have grated 2 cucumbers, nice big grates. I guess you can't see it because of the light, but these are nice big chunks. These are not small cucumbers. I have grated it with big blade. So yes. We'll start up with our pressure cooker. Today we'll be doing it in pressure cooker. And because we are just,
I was going to ask you, what don't you have in this recipe?
Yeah, actually.
All right.
These are actually all the things that...
Yeah, I think I got all the ingredients recorded. Vegetables, potatoes, rice, onions, tomatoes, green chilies, ginger, bay leaves, peppercorn, starseed anise, and the amounts I'm also writing, trying to. something in seeds.
Mustard seeds.
Cumin seeds.
Cumin seeds and mustard seeds as well.
And mustard seeds, garlic, ginger garlic paste, curry ginger leaves, coriander paste. Leaves, ghee, yes. Salt, sunflower oil, mustard seed, and cucumbers.
Yes.
That's the longest list of ingredients. So bravo.
True. So,
awesome.
Sunflower oil is actually optional. You can use your, flavored oil, olive oil or groundnut oil. Or if we go towards southern India, we can also find people using coconut oil.
Mm-hmm.
Nice, fresh coconut oil for the same tadka. So here I'm taking 3 to 4 spoons of oil. This is sunflower oil, which we prefer here at home. But yes, this is nice low fat oil because we'll also be using clear butter. That's key. This is 4 spoons oil and just 1/2 tablespoon of clear butter into the same. We'll keep it in medium flame because we don't want the butter to be burnt. Starting up with adding the all the raw and dry spices, peppercorns, bay leaves, star anise, and cumin seeds.
Sureka, tell us about the pan you're using. What is that?
This is a pressure cooker.
Pressure cooker. Okay, sorry.
It's a pressure cooker. So I'm adding the ginger garlic paste into it. Just 1/2 of it. Because the 1/2 we want it for later. And please do remember, please do not leave this wooden spatula or the wooden spoon inside the oil. This might stick to the base of the vessel or the pan, whichever you are using. We are taking 10 to 12. Yeah, I can see, I can hear someone singing.
Meher Chan Nori is just in bliss. You know, we're just going to have to ask.
He just enjoys the dishes, or maybe he is enjoying himself.
Yeah, he's excited.
Jai Baba Uncle. Yes, thank
you. Hyderabad biryani.
Yeah, now, I'll try. So yeah, so now we have added 9 to 10 curry leaves directly in the oil, because we want the flavor to be in the oil and to mix it well with the rice. I'm adding 2 small onions. These are roughly chopped onions. We haven't shaped it anything, nor cubical, nor circular, because we have different texture, different, you know, shapes of vegetables that we have used, because we don't want any uniformity in the vegetables. I have cubed sliced the carrot. I have just broken it using my hands, the cauliflower. And I have broken the beans into 4, 1 beans into 3 or 4. And that's it. These are different styles and we want it. We want it to be different shape. So yes, after onions, we'll drop in this 1/2 tablespoon of salt. That's just for the onions and the vegetables that we'll be adding up.
Hello, Harishankar.
I don't know who that is, but please stay muted. Thank you.
Yes, I'm removing the spatula, the wooden spoon, every time I take off my hand from the pressure cooker. I'm adding the potatoes in this. This is just a single potato. I have removed the skin, peeled off the skin. And these are big, nice chunks. And yes, you would like to keep it in water so that it doesn't darken itself. And yeah, for this dish, we are not using any turmeric powder because we want the pulao to be white and fresh and all the vegetables to look nice and bright. It's easier to keep the handle to your left because you can hold it while stirring it.
Yeah. Rekha, can you show one of the potatoes to get an idea of the size?
Yes, it's just this size.
Okay, so it's good size.
Cube size. Yeah, it's nice and big because we'll be taking just a single whistle in the pressure cooker. because we are going to pre-cook some of the vegetables, like before adding the rice. So there is capsicum, carrot, cauliflower, and beans. You can also add, any other vegetable that you like. You can add mushroom for that sake. I'm just adding half because I guess it's more for just a cup of rice. There are going to be vegetable scales into this, and we would like to remove that. Now I'll add green chilies because we want the green chilies to be nice and fresh. We are just adding it after the vegetables. So these are nice 4 to 5 green chilies sliced vertically.
Do you take the seeds out?
No, actually, the seeds are the main ingredient. Those add the spice.
The hotness.
Yes, the hotness. But I have removed the seeds of capsicum because we don't want that. That's too chunky seeds that comes into that. And we don't want that to be, disturbing our flavors. So I'll just add some coriander leaves for our vegetables to have coriander flavor. I'm giving it a dump. It's just keeping it closed without the lid being inside. It's just closed roughly. So we want the vegetables to cook, the ingredients to mix up together. And we will be cooking it around 30 to 40% because we are going to take a whistle. And I guess a whistle is what the term you use there, Farishte. Or is it something else that you want to add up?
Yeah, I learned that from my Indian buddy, Hari. She used to call it a whistle. The thing is, our pressure cookers nowadays are like the hot instant pot. And they're
right.
Yeah, they're electrical, so we don't actually have it on the stove. So we have to just individually translate. Vegetable in my hot pot is 6 minutes or something, very small. So I think we have to do a very short amount of time so that they
It can be 6 to 7 minutes because we have soaked in the rice and we want the rice to be, separated nicely. We want it to be individual and not stick together. So I have washed it 3 to 4 times to remove the starch nicely. Mm-hmm. And this is clean water in which I have soaked it. So I'll just drain the water out because we want the starch to be removed. If there is starch, the rice are going to stick up together and we don't want that mushy look. So yes, I have removed the water now. This is 15 minutes now that I have soaked. I soaked it at 8:15 and I kept it till maybe 8:30, 8:35 and I'm removing the water.
When you soak the rice,
now is the
Sureka, when you soak the rice, do you add salt to it or no?
No, it's without salt. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so these vegetables are cooked for around 2 to 3 minutes now, and I can see they are getting translucent. Now we'll add tomato. This is just one big tomato, or you can use two small tomatoes, and these are also big. I have used big slices, not using small. And we are adding tomato for the tangy flavor that we want, because we have all the flavors in this. We have subtle flavors, we have crunchy texture, and we also have big, nice, bulky things inside, cauliflower and potato I'm addressing to. So I've added tomato. I'll give it a steam again. just for half a minute or something. And yes, I have removed the water from the rice because we want the rice to be separate. We want it to have an individual shape. And I'm keeping it everything in medium flame. It's not low, it's not high. But yes, if you find it getting burnt downside in the bottom of the vessel, you can definitely reduce the flame because I'm using a big burner. So in this, I'm using a medium flame. That means maybe more than medium flame in a small burner. Yes, this dam is good. I'm dropping it the rice finally. Jai Baba.
Jai
Baba. Want it to be nice and healthy and individual. So before mixing it directly with the vegetable, we'll be adding clear butter and just turn and twist the rice using our wooden stick or any spatula that we are using. I like using my fingers, but this is hot. I'm adding half a tablespoon of butter. I'll just be flipping it from the top. I'm not flipping it with the vegetable. I'm coating each and every rice. Sorry. And yes, it's melted and every rice is coated nicely. Now I'll just flip and turn, and we are not going to add water. Now we'll be giving it a steam for around 1 minute or 2 minutes so that the vegetable flavors are nicely mixed up with the rice. I have my cat fighting.
She's our cooking kitty companion.
Yes, the cooking kitty companion. She's hungry and she has just returned from her evening walk.
Oh.
We leave her outside and she comes back and it's like she shouts at the door. Like, take me inside. Yes, so the rice is nicely mixed. You can see the different colors inside.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Now we'll give it a steam just for half a minute or a minute in medium flame. Yes. And meanwhile, this rice is cooking. We can give tadka to our salad. Now, Indians give tadka to each and everything, I suppose, because salads are normally raw. But this is a different style of salad. I have now nicely creased and nicely grated cucumber. Yes. Before the rice starts sticking to the pan, I'll add, I have measured it and I have kept, this is 1.5 cup, the same cup of your rice measurement cup, 1.5 cup of water. Because it is pre-soaked, we'll just be taking a single whistle. And before that, you definitely want to taste the salt. And I feel the salt is required.
Sureka, did you say you put 1.5 cup of rice initially and now you're adding 1.5 cup water?
No, it's just 1 cup rice and 1.5 cup of water. Okay. 1 cup water for rice and 1/2 cup water for all the vegetables to sink in.
Acha.
Yes, acha.
It's about the only word I know.
You know, I was shocked. I was surprised actually. It felt good, but I heard Alan speaking Marathi here with all the aunties, all the Maushi who are working at the Samadhi.
Wagner?
He normally reads poem during Dhuni.
Yes, Alan Wagner has been living in India for a long time, so yes.
Yeah, he said it's around 40 to 45 years that he's here. Mm-hmm. And yes, He was with Mehramai. He has nice experiences with Mehramai, nice experiences with Mani Aunty. Now, taking Baba's name, we are setting up the pressure cooker. Sometimes the pressure cookers don't get the whistle, so we'll be, you know, taking it down after 10 minutes. I'll just see what's the time. It's 8:47. By 8:57 or 9 o'clock, we should have a whistle. Or even before, if it's, you know, nice person to eat. Yeah. So, yes, I'll keep it aside in the burner that's behind. If we want to give a tadka to our salad, medium flame that I'm keeping it.
Your kitchen is marvelous.
Thank you. Yeah, it's actually, we love cooking here because everything is nice. You need a nice kitchen to be cooking it very interestingly. So we have the small kadai. We have even the small, just a cup size kadai as well. But I'm using this so that it's visible. You even get a kadai with a single hand if we are doing a tadka on the top. I'll keep this here. I hope the burner is not hot. Yes, I can keep it here. So yes, this is the salad tadka, which we'll be having. So I can hear the whistle coming shortly. So I'm reducing the flame because we want the rice to cook perfectly. Yeah, this pan is ready. I'll add just half a tablespoon of oil to this, because we don't want the freshness of the salad to be taken over by the oil. So for the tadka, we'll use 2 to 3 curry leaves. Just a single teaspoon mustard seed. Teaspoon, I suppose I'm right. Yes, it's teaspoon.
Yes.
But we measure it with hand, actually. So it's like just a small hole of seeds, but yes, you can say it's just a single teaspoon because we want the mustard seeds to coat all the crunches, all the slice of the cucumber. Yes, it has started crackling. I'm adding curry leaves. I'll switch off the flame. It's just a half a minute task to give this tadka. I'll add coriander leaves on the top. I'll use a spoon to mix it nicely. And definitely we will require to add half a tablespoon of salt to the oil, to the curry leaves and mustard seeds, so that it coats our cucumber. Once this is done, we are just going to drop it on the top. And before serving, we'll mix it thoroughly and nicely. You can also add, some black gram, split black gram for the texture. And also, you can add, for the spice, you can add green chili. So yes, the tadka is ready on the top of our salad. So we'll keep it aside to Baba. We'll let him enjoy the salad first.
So we have a comment from Yasmin. Tadka, tempering spices, Gujarati. Is that right? Yeah, so... Yes, yes. So you basically tempered the spices, the bay leaves, the mustard.
Yes.
Well, you the first mustard seeds. Then they have to crackle, and bay leaves, and then.
Those were curry leaves for this. We haven't used mustard seeds for biryani for this pulao, but we have used cumin seeds in pulao, and this.
Yeah, for this.
Yes, for this we have just used curry leaves, sliced coriander leaves, and mustard seeds.
Okay.
Just a single teaspoon mustard seed. Yes.
Can you also throw in chopped garlic?
No, actually, because we have ginger garlic paste in here and we want its individuality to be shown.
Got it.
Yeah.
She's a true purist.
This is the first time I'm seeing rice cooked in a pressure cooker. Never done that.
Perfect balance.
You know, if you have an electric pressure cooker, you can also use the same for doing this. Just cook the vegetables aside in a single, pan or something, and drop them into the electric pressure in the vessel of the electric cooker, and drop in the rice, equalize the water, and that will be done.
Using an electric device to cook rice is like blasphemy. It's like insulting God.
Absolutely, you're right.
Because I have made it in an electric pressure cooker. Yes, yeah. it's actually a blessing because I have been using electric pressure cooker in my mother's place, when I was in Pune that time, and it was like super time saver. You just need not check anything; it just switches off. It turns off as the rice is cooked. I don't know what the science that they have used in manufacturing that device, that appliance, but yes, it's super time saver. Because when I was in Pune, I was working in a company, and I used to make all the things in the morning for my tiffin box, for my lunch box, I should pack myself and I leave. So in the morning routine, that was my time too.
There's the whistle.
Wow.
So we have a clear white whistle, a plain whistle, and I'm not cooling it right away. I let it to cool naturally, because if we release the pressure cooker, it's a fear. It's actually a nightmare to open a pressure cooker for me, because if the water, the juice of the same comes out, that means we are losing some flavors and we don't want that to happen. So I'll just let it cool naturally, and
patience is the key for these recipes.
Yes, definitely. It's just what is required, and it's just what the pulao asks me. I can see my pulao asking me, give me my space.
That's sweet.
Yes.
It's going to be incredible.
Before we move on, are these videos recorded and kept somewhere so we can go back and refer to them?
Yes, Darius. Yes. We are uploading them as we speak, and it's on the YouTube channel of the Circle of Friends. They're available.
Okay.
And Sureka and I take notes for the recipes, and I type it up and send it to Sureka, and she reviews and makes it perfect. And then we are planning to include the recipes under the description of each video.
It feels like the dishes are half cooked by first day there.
No. I'm just a note taker.
I should start making videos of my cooking. I normally just take photographs and then I put them into a recipe and I put them up on my recipe site, and too lazy to do the video part.
Yeah, well, your platform, you can definitely, you're welcome to start your own cooking show. We have time on the calendar. So yes, talk to Angela.
Okay.
Thank you. I am not sure I didn't get time to read the name. Someone just wrote Michelle.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Actually, I talk to each and everything. I talk to my shoes, my comb, everything, my mirror.
I talk
to the Baba statue that we have, a small face statue. So I sometimes ask him, how are you? You're smiling. I'm you're just smiling. Are you talking
I'm just was so like, in my kitchen, but I didn't want to. And now I'm in my workspace. But it's so cute. You're cooking. It's so cute.
Thank you.
Adorable. Thank you. Thanks.
But so I'm making me so hungry. I just have my shake, and I'm going, oh, now what? What to cook?
Yes, it's actually, we feel like there are too many ingredients, but once you start, you know, feeling your food, and once you start, you know, tasting every bit of your food, you'll remember that what all ingredients are there in your mouth right now. So mostly whenever we visit a restaurant, I take a spoon and I start to recall what all flavors are coming in my mouth. So that makes easier for me rather than asking the chef who is in the restaurant to tell me what he has actually cooked. So I try to imitate the same. And luckily,
that's a gift, you know that. That's the gift of being a chef. You can take it and tear it apart. My cousin and I do. Yeah, yeah. Like, what's in this? How is this made? What's this? And then you go,
very refined.
So the pressure cooker is, you know, it's releasing the aroma, actually. And yes, I think just maybe in 2 or 3 minutes, it will be ready to open it and place it for Baba. And here.
Yes, very good. Well, the salad, let's take a look at the salad, too.
Yes. So, we can, you know, twist and turn this because we'll be serving it now. You'll be plating it down. Mm-hmm. So I'm mixing everything. And you can also see the water that the cucumber is releasing. And that's the topping, you know, actually. If you want, you can just spread this over your pulao and you can have it as it is.
Sureka, the word tatka, is that salad? Or what is the word tatka
the
mean?
The tatka is what we have done in the small kadai, in the small pan.
Tempering.
Tatka is the, yes, tempering. Yeah.
Okay. And you just call the salads cucumber salad, right?
Cucumber seasoning. Seasoning.
Yes. Maybe you can also say sizzling because, you know, we are crackling the mustard seeds and dropping in the curry leaves that are nice and hot. And we are just pouring it on the top of nice, cool cucumbers. So it's nice.
Amazing. Actually,
you can try it right away. If you have a cucumber at your home, you can have a bowl full of that. This is actually a blessing during summer because we lose so much water and we want the water content in our body. So,
yes.
Ta-da! Ta-da! So, yes, I have released the lock. And once it is done, it will drop off automatically. But I don't want the top of the shape to be, you know, releasing the pressure slowly.
Amazing that you've been able to cook all this in 30 minutes. That blows my mind.
Yeah. But yeah, you know, preparing for this took me a half an hour more. So it's, you know, but if you are doing everything, chopping and everything, you know, we have got the chopped packs ready in our, you know, DMart or Big Bazaar here. So whatever supermarket bazaar you have for vegetable, they have started making this vegetable pulao pack. You know, all the vegetable directly ready for you to drop into your tadka. There is one more thing that if your whistle has water, that means we have excess water in the pressure cooker. So we have got a clear whistle. That means there is no excess water in this and we have perfect, you know, water. Yes. Yeah.
It's amazing.
That is the perfect consistency. We don't want any excess water. You can see the different colors in this.
It's beautiful.
I'll just place it and I'll show you guys.
What's the difference between a pulao and a biryani?
a pulao has all the vegetables, and a biryani we don't make it too spicy. And when it's a biryani, we have apart from the raw spices, we have other masalas as well. We'll have red chili powder, we'll have coriander powder, we'll have some garam masala powder, and that makes it super hot. And this is something subtle which you can have it with any of the other curries that you're making that day, coconut curry, tomato puree, or plain dal.
Yeah.
So this is, and also it is good to have it with cottage cheese, that is paneer. I was actually planning for making palak paneer, that is spinach. You can see the rice individual and it's not sticking together.
Beautiful. Yes, palak paneer next time.
Definitely. It's actually the most favorite dish of Praveen. He usually asks, if he's sick, he'll ask me to make palak paneer. Anyone to my mother-in-law or me. Yes, the rice are perfectly cooked. I'm actually surprised myself because this is the rice I'm using very first time. I usually use the regular rice that we eat. But yes, this is perfect. So on the top, I'll go ahead, some coriander.
When the cook is happy, that means it came out perfect.
Yes.
Which is every time with this cook. Oh, wow.
So we have this ready.
Beautiful.
Beautiful.
So nice.
It's hot, and yes, I can, use the spoon and show you the rice. It's not sticking together.
Yeah.
And the potato, I'm just cutting it into half, and you can see it's not meshy and it's perfect. In perfect shape as well.
That's the key. And you want to have
The key.
Yeah.
When you start talking with your food, it says, yes, this is time up. I've been cooked. Yeah. You can see this rice.
So sweet.
Individual. So I'm very happy.
Surekha, it is absolutely beautiful. Thank you. Does anyone have any questions for Surekha before we let her enjoy this incredible production? Anyone, any questions?
Oh, Jai Baba, thank you.
Hi, Michelle. Jai Baba. Now I can see your face. Actually, it was dark last time.
Oh, yeah. Jai Baba. I was walking down the stairs and now I'm in the studio. I need to get to work. But it's always good to have tips.
Thank you.
Bereshte is a fabulous cook, you know. She makes Persian food. When are we going to have that too?
We are definitely waiting for Bereshte to cook something for us.
Thank you.
Definitely. And also, Darius to cook something for us. And I guess each and everyone, there is different taste in everyone's hand. I cannot cook the same food as my mother cooks or my mother-in-law cooks. So individual hand has individual taste and flavors.
Wonderful. Beautiful.
Yes.
I'm going to pause or stop the recording so we can say avatar, Meher Baba, Ki Jai.
And then, thank you, Yasmin. Avatar, Meher Baba, Ki Jai.
Avatar.